Hi, this is Chef Janie Pendleton, and today I'm going to be teaching you how to make your own underarm deodorant. Now, my underarm deodorant also serves as an antiperspirant, so if you're having problems with a little bit of wetness, watch and learn, because I'm going to teach you how to get rid of that to use the antiperspirant instead of just the baking soda, which just absorbs the odors. You're also going to use either arrowroot or cornstarch, which also helps keep you dry. Now, your natural body needs to sweat. That's just natural, but it's the chemicals in your body that mixes with the air and the oxygen that actually becomes the odorous part, you know, the bacterial part of your sweat, and that's the part that stinks. And there are several things that we can use, natural herbs that we can use, that stops that actual odor from happening. To sweat is a good thing. Your body needs to sweat. It needs to release body fluid. So that's actually a good thing, but we don't want it showing on our armpits. This is also easy to wash out of your clothes, especially with my homemade laundry detergent, which you can also find on my YouTube channel site. So what we're going to start with is 1 teaspoon of extra virgin olive oil. Now, olive oil, as we all know, is also a antibacterial element. So when you add this, even just straight up, when you add this, just a little bit of it, to your deodorant, you're already getting an antibacterial property. Now here I've chose some cloves. You can do nutmeg, cinnamon sticks, whatever. And you can do powder or clove form. Here I put both in my oil. Put it in a ramekin, and I microwaved it at 30 second intervals until it's nice and hot, and we got that flavoring, that scent, into our olive oil. Now you're saying, oh my God, that's gonna stain my shirt. That's black. It looks like coffee grounds. Yes, it does. But look what I've got here. I actually have a coffee filter inside just a regular drinking cup that I've kind of folded over the top, and I'm just going to strain that. And we're gonna get that back into the clear coloring of the olive oil. Now the reason why I'm doing this is because cloves are actually a really good scent that covers up the olive oil smell. I don't like the smell of olive oil. Not for my armpits, okay? But it also is one of the top ingredients for antibacterial herbs. So between the olive oil and the cloves, okay? So we're just going to let this drain, and you can see down here, we're going to end up with about a half a teaspoon of olive oil, which is about what you need, between a half a teaspoon to a teaspoon. You can double this recipe. Okay, so while that's draining, we're going to set that aside, and I'm going to show you the other ingredients. Here we're also going to use 1/4 cup of coconut oil. This is organic. A good coconut oil will have a nice sweet coconut scent to it. We're also going to use 1 teaspoon of cocoa butter, straight up cocoa butter. This is my favorite brand. I picked it up for $1 at the Big Lots. Can't beat that. It just happened to be my favorite brand. We're also going to use 1/4 cup of baking soda. It's not baking powder. It's baking soda. And make sure that it's aluminum free. Make sure it's organic. And then here, we're going to use 1/4 cup of cornstarch or arrowroot powder. Now I'm out of my arrowroot powder, so I'm just gonna go ahead and show this to you with cornstarch. But arrowroot powder actually has some more antibacterial properties in it. So you're probably better off using the arrowroot powder. And you can get that at Berry Farm Foods, any organic, berryfarms.com online is where I get most of my gluten-free items, like my tapioca flours and things like that. So, okay, now here, the more oils you add and the thinner consistency you get this, you can just put this on with 2 fingers under your arm and kind of smear it in and just use a glass container like this, okay? But I like mine to apply it. I'm kind of lazy there and I don't really like it in my hand in it after I've had a bath. This is good for you. You can rub this into your hands. This is a great hand moisturizer as well. So, this is safe for you, safe for your kids, safe for the baby's bottom. This is good stuff. And you can even put a little baby powder in this too if you like the baby powder scent. But make sure you get aluminum-free and chemical-free baby powder if you take that route. Now, what I've got here is I've just got my empty my old empty container here, and I've turned this all the way down. You can see, you can wash this up if you want to, it's not necessary. And then, and I like the scent. This was called the Coconut Kiss, and I really like that scent. So when I put in the rest of my essential oils, I'm gonna try to go for that cocoa, coconut scent. So the cocoa butter will help with the cocoa in this, and then it has a little bit of a coconut scent, and I'm gonna add that in as well. So we have that kind of going here, but a few little drops of essential oil, that's fine. Now if you wanna use tea tree oil, you can, that's a good antibacterial oil. I personally don't like the scent of tea tree oil, okay? You can add peppermint, that's another good antibacterial oil. You can use oregano. Now I know that doesn't sound appetizing, but believe it or not, that's a really good, if you ever get food poisoning, keep oregano oil on hand, because that's really good for to clear up your stomach infections and stuff. Lemon thyme, French thyme, anything in that family works. Eucalyptus oils, which I don't care for eucalyptus, it's a little bit too strong for me, but hey, they even put that in toothpaste, right? So honey is really great. We all know the benefits of honey. It's like olive oil, it's just really, really good for you. I mean, the benefits are beyond our knowledge. And vinegar. Vinegar is a really good antibacterial as well, and we know that vinegar is natural and can go in anything as well. So these are all things that you can use in your homemade products, and there's so many more things. Just go online and just get a notebook out and just start writing it down and start studying it and start experimenting with your own products, and I guarantee you'll come up with something that you're extremely happy with. Now, it looks like my coffee filter is done draining. So you can see all the impurities are here. And looky there, we're back to the olive oil. Mmm, and it smells like, it gave it a nice spicy scent and it got rid of that strong olive oil smell. Okay, now I'm going to decide on what other scents I wanna add to this before I get started. There's imitation rum, lemon, strawberry, butter, cherry, cinnamon, anise, and more vanilla. So so cherry would probably be a really good scent to put in this, but I wanted to stick with that coconut, cocoa butter, coconut kind of flair. So I think using the butter extract would probably be my best bet into coming up with that scent, and maybe a little bit of the vanilla. But yeah, you could make this a strawberry kiss scent and make it strawberry, make it cherry. Okay, so now we're gonna set that aside. We're gonna put these in last. We're gonna start out by adding equal parts cornstarch. That's one, two, and three. It's about a quarter of a cup. And we're gonna do the same thing with our baking soda. Guess if it's not coming out as well. I'm ambidextrous. I can do things right and left-handed, but when things are giving me difficulty, I always turn to the right hand. I don't know why that is, but I guess because I'm more right-handed than I am left-handed, but yeah, I'm strange that way. Okay, so we've got about a quarter of a cup of each in here. Mix that together really well, and the best thing you're going to use here is a whisk. Just whisk all that together really well. There we go. And the more you get this broke up anyway, the better, because we're going to get a nice chalky consistency here in just a minute. We're just going to go ahead and add our cocoa butter. And I'm just going to add a nice heaping tablespoon of that, maybe just a hair bit more. I like the way that it smells. And I like the nice creamy consistency of that. And then here, of course, we're gonna add our olive oil right on top of that cocoa butter. I'm gonna kind of blend that together first. Okay, kind of blend that olive oil into the cocoa butter and then in to our powder mixture here. And then we're just going to start smashing it in like this. Now over here, in hot water, I laid my jar of coconut oil. Now be careful, this can get slippery. Okay. And I'm going to make several wells into my mixture here. You can see here where the hot water in the sink melted my coconut oil, and I just want to add a little bit in each hole there. That's plenty right there, okay? And then we're just going to start blending that together like this until we get a nice... What we want to do here is when we compact this, we want it to be compactable, kind of like a snowball is compactable with that much moisture, where it doesn't crumble and fall apart. But if you get it too moist, that's fine. You can add just more cornstarch or arrowroot powder. Or you can just make it a cream and you can add it to your glass jar and then just dip into it two fingers and put it on your armpit like that. But we want to fill these containers, so we want it to be... And we're going to add the scents last. Okay, I'm just going to keep going here. You can use a metal spoon, a wood spoon, it doesn't really matter. I'm using plastic. I'm going to add just a little bit more. Matter of fact, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to make another little, a couple more wells here to kind of add my more coconut oil in. Just a little. Doesn't take that much. Be surprised. This is already smelling really good. And let me tell you something. If you read the back of one of these things, it has ingredients in it that I cannot even pronounce, and I wouldn't want to, okay? These are scientists that put this together. The thing about it is really, is this good for you? I mean, you are supposed to sweat. You know, maybe on a night where you're wearing your black, little sexy black dress or whatever, you can use something like this. But for everyday use around the house or at work or whatever, I'm in construction. I'm around big sweaty men all day long every day. I don't think they really care what I smell like at that stage. Now, this is really working here for me. I'm going to go ahead and test it out here. And what we want, you can kind of mix this with your hands if you like, but you want to make it so when this is compacted, does it hold together? That needs a little bit more liquids. Okay, so I'm just going to kind of hand mix that now. Almost there. Remember, coconut oil is sensitive to heat. So if it's a really hot day outside, you might want to even store this. If it's in this form, in your bar form here, your container form, you might want to store it in the refrigerator. Okay, I've got this mixed together, and I've added my scents. And all I used was regular baking extracts. That's fine. It has alcohol in it, but that helps actually to keep you dry. It's got the same, it's got either vodka or rum in the alcohol when they soak it. Matter of fact, today I'm going to be making my own vanilla extract, and I'm going to be teaching you how to do that in just a minute. And we're going to make it almost by the quart. So, and trust me, it's better than any imitation version that you can buy on the market to make the real thing. But I use these right here, of course, for when I make my laundry detergents and my fabric softeners and, you know, and my laundry crystal booster. So I keep these on hand. You can use the essence oils. That's fine. They're more organic. But, I mean, for the scent and everything and for the money you're saving, I still use the regular extracts that you can buy at the store. Because we're not in a big town and I just can't get what everybody else can. Okay? So in order to make my my deodorant smell like my favorite secret expressions, which was Cocoa Butter Kiss, and I mean, I got a stronger scented version of it here. Of course, you know we put the cocoa smelling stuff in it originally, and of course we had the coconut oil in it, which had a scent, and that pretty much would have done it. With a little bit of cloves, that pretty much got it. But when I added a couple of drops of vanilla and the butter, and just a hint of the lemon, wow, I got this smell in 2 to 3-fold. It just, the whole room smells of this wonderful vanilla, buttery, lemon scent. The cocoa butter and the coconut, I mean, you can just combine all that in your favorite dessert and you have this scent, and it is absolutely, it's awesome. I'm really happy with it. And if your child eats this by accident, hey, I guess It's not poisonous, so that's a good thing. At least you know what's going on in your armpit. You know what your children are wearing. And my daughters, they will like this new scent I just came up with as well. They're going to love this. Okay, so now we've got this into a compactive stage. See how that just holds itself together like a really fine dough. Yet when you go like this, it kind of crumbles apart. We're just going to start filling these up. Compressing it really well all the way down. Make sure your dial's turned all the way down. Make sure you get a full bar in here. And you just want to compress this really tight. Okay, and you're just going to keep filling this up until you get it nice and full. I mean, look, I've got enough here for a couple more bars. Believe it or not, think about this, okay? I'm doing this one-handed, so it's kind of sloppy. But even at the dollar store, with a coupon, I paid $268. So I paid $268 for this with a coupon. That was a 50-cent coupon. If I take it to a store where they doubled the coupon, then, you know, I would have done a little better. $218. So that's fine. But I just made 3 to 4 containers of this. Are you ready for this? $1.15. Okay, $1.15, and I'm counting the full price of some of these things here. So $1.15 for all 4 of them. $1.15 for all 4 containers. Okay, that's crazy. I could sit here all day and save that kind of money. And it's your paycheck. You can spend it wherever you want to, but if you can make it and have basically the same results and smell just as clean, you know, why not? But anyway, I'm gonna take and finish filling this, and I'll be back. Now we're just going to cap these, and we're going to put them in the refrigerator. My refrigerator's full. We just got back from the grocery store. I'm just going to put these up here in the refrigerator for about 4 to 5 hours or overnight. And that will help make them help them solidify a little bit. Help that that melted coconut oil kind of get kind of solid again. I mean, it's pretty cool in here because it's winter time, so it's already solidifying on its own. This is Chef Janie Pendleton on how to make your own deodorant. Enjoy.